when you were gone. Yeah. And it was important for him because he detested what went on in the other Super Bowl.
Yeah.
And he has been very vocal about that. And he even brought up something that I've heard a lot of the stuff.
Is this about the introductions?
The introductions, which I had never heard before. Is that a true story?
Coach Fossil came into one of these meetings, I think it was Wednesday or Thursday, and said, hey, look, we're going to introduce the defense. I mean, it was all lined up. And I remember specifically driving to this game with Greg Camella because we drove every game together. And we're talking to each other. We're free agents. He's a free agent. We said, you know what, this could be the last game we play here together. You know, let's enjoy it. And then I remember him saying, but just think, if we win this game, we're going to be introduced in the Super Bowl. All right? That's what we said before the NFC Championship game where we destroyed the Minnesota Vikings. Midway through that week, Super Bowl week, down in Tampa, Florida, Coach Fossil comes into the meeting and says, you know, we're going to introduce the defense. You know, we'll be back at some point, so the offense will get a chance, but the defense got us here. And I can't tell you
how much. You guys were furious.
Not only were we furious, I can't tell you the emotional letdown that a lot of us felt. Because getting introduced at a Super Bowl is.
So think about this.
It's one of the greatest things that ever happened.
You're going to play a great. You're coming off a 41-0 win. You are riding high. And he has made other claims, which I'll get to in a minute, but before that he didn't make the other day, but he made this claim about the offense-defense thing, which I had never heard before. The defense, there was always strife in the Coughlin years between the offense and the defense.
In the Fossil years,
there was always an offense-defense fight going on there. There was a lot of that going on then. So they decide they want to be introduced. Now you guys are ticked off.
Yes.
How was that? Did you guys have a confrontation with them at any point before the Super Bowl?
We didn't.
So you guys just got mad.
Maybe we should have.
So instead you just harbored some ill will.
It was disappointing, Mike, to say the least.
And it bothered the offense.
It bothered us immensely. It was something we talked about for 2 days leading up to the game.
Now the coach, that's a bad job by him for not straightening that out.
Well, I mean, it's one of the problems that you get when a coach is so intimately involved in only one side of a team. You know, Coach Fossil is an offensive guy. He's calling the plays for, you know, some of his career. As a head coach, and he was intimately involved with the offensive side. He wasn't so involved with the defensive side, and it's a challenge for coaches. It's a challenge for Sean Payton, I'm sure.
Absolutely.
I mean, they've been able to mitigate it to a large extent in New Orleans, but it becomes an issue when something like this comes up because it becomes us versus them.
So you guys didn't say to him, "Hey, Coach, go take care of this."
Well,
the
problem was the decision was already made. It wasn't a discussion. Okay. Nobody on the offensive side of the ball was even consulted about it, and it put a sour taste in our mouth.
Well, there was also this feeling that I've heard Amani say before. He didn't say it this week, but I've heard him say this before. He has said this to me before, that he felt that Fossil chickened out. That he was afraid to actually let you guys play full out against the Ravens. He didn't think he could block them. He was intimidated by them. And that was his big mistake, that he didn't let your offense go attack
the
Ravens.
And it's funny you say that, because here's something that's very interesting. And it's pertinent, because Sean Payton is coaching in his second Super Bowl now. He was an assistant offensive coordinator with us then.
But Jim had taken away a lot of his power that year.
He did, but not fully. He took it away fully the following year, and that's what ultimately led to the deterioration. And he left to go to greener pastures. But at halftime of that game, it was 10-0.
10-0.
We were pinned back all the way the whole first half, but we weren't getting destroyed. You know, our defense was holding up. Offensively, we were doing just enough. Halftime in the Super Bowl, you know, is like 30 minutes, which is a death knell because it gives you too much time to think and overanalyze. We came out with a second half game plan to essentially get into our 2-minute offense and hurry up offense to try to get the Baltimore Ravens off guard. What happened? Kerry Collins calls a play at the line of scrimmage. He picks up his foot to take the snap, looking down. He looks up. The defense is different. As a result, he throws 5 interceptions, and it ends up being a blowout. Sean Payton, I think Coach Fossil, probably collaborating together, they picked the wrong game halftime adjustment, and it put us in a situation in an offense that we hadn't run for the last 2 months. Because you remember the last part of that season, we were dominating.
You're playing great.
We went to Indianapolis. Yeah.
We ran
the table 7 games in a row, and we were put in a situation to play an offense that we hadn't been perfecting.
So
over
you
the
think
last few years.
Now Ernie had made the point in his book that he felt Kerry was out of the game from the beginning, intimidated by that Ravens. You think
so
at halftime you thought you were still in the game then?
No, I think we were still in
and
that.
And you
game.
Think that
well,
he
you remember the interception. Interception for a touchdown.
Hey, I mean, George Young was furious. A defensive hold on Keith Hamilton, which is never called.
Especially on a play fake
on
a screen pass.
Never called. That was a terrible call.
I agree.
Should have been a different game.
I agree.
And, you know, so you think if he had made the right adjustment, you'd think it wasn't more the game plan. You thought it was that you guys just made the wrong adjustment
at
halftime.
Well, we went into a two-minute offense, right. Mike, and we just didn't execute it well at all. It put Kerry in a very difficult situation against probably one of the best defenses that the NFL has ever seen. That season, we were running the ball so effectively. We were doing it in so many different ways, misdirection, et cetera. The shell shot for us came with the speed of the Baltimore Ravens front seven, mainly that we couldn't get to Ray Lewis.
Well, so that play Ray made on you, which is still one of the most amazing plays I've ever seen a guy make.
I agree.
I was right in front of me in the stands, and I said, oh, my God. Yeah. Now, I'm not the biggest fan of his. I never saw anybody run that fast.
You know what, Mike? That was my oh, my God moment.
I never saw anybody close that fast.
When we called it, I said, okay, we have a chance on this play. You know, you could see when we got up to the line of scrimmage, we have a chance on this play. And we're running the stretch all the way to the left, and I see the lane. And then all of a sudden,
he comes flying.
And I remember getting up and saying, could somebody just blank and touch Ray Lewis? Nobody could touch him.
No.
The whole game. And so we couldn't run the ball, which forced us into this halftime.
They were just too good, right?
They were just great.
They were just too good.
Offensively,
we haven't seen a defense.
They made a couple plays, but they weren't world beaters,
right.
But their defense was second to none in a lot of ways.
But he did bring up that story the other day, so that really was a big deal.
I mean, we're grown-ups. We should be able to get over it. But at the end of the day,
I had never heard that all these years.
Mike, we're playing a kid's sport. You know, you want to feel that euphoria of being introduced at the Super Bowl, and especially after having thought about it for 2 weeks, we're thinking about this, and all of a sudden, it's like right before you get your lollipop, your mom says, you know what, you can't have it.
Unbelievable. All right, we'll take a break. We'll get the update in with him, and then we'll talk some more with Tiki about some TV stuff right after this.